Minnie Miñoso deserves to be in the Hall of Fame because he was excellent on the field in the midst of the most important transformation of professional baseball in the United States. He was one of baseball's integration pioneer, changing how we would cheer with each other and for each other. When Minnie Miñoso made his debut on May 1st, 1951, he was a Black Cuban who was integrating the Chicago White Sox. And what that meant for the other Afro-Latinos, for the Cubans and Puerto Ricans and Dominicans who aspired to play in MLB, was that door had started to creak open, and more of them would gain the opportunity. It wasn't just that he was a first, but he became one of the best players.
Minnie Miñoso gets the jump by cracking out a home run on the first inning.
From game one, hitting a home run in his first at-bat throughout that season, becoming an all-star.
Minnie Miñoso lashes the ball off the screen in right center for a double. It extends the American League lead.
Minnie was one of the top players in the American League, period. Miñoso played in the Negro League, and Minnie transforms the Chicago White Sox. The Go-Go White Sox was embracing the Negro League style that Jackie Robinson and other Black ball players brought over, stealing bases, running, taking the extra base. And Minnie was one of those guys who loved to steal bases, who tried to run the bases as smartly as possible, and always take the extra base. Make the defense stop you. And the Southsiders loved it. There was even a song called When Miñoso al Bate.
Minnie Miñoso, go, 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 cha-cha-cha, ooh, cha-cha-cha, ooh.
And it goes that when Miñoso comes up the bat, the ball does a cha-cha-cha. We would call him a five-tool player, and he'd use all of those five tools to beat you. And that was part of the transformation of the White Sox into a team that would go to the World Series against the Dodgers and would be a contender. Many inspired others, like Louis Tiant, like Clemente, like Orlando Cepeda. When Orlando Cepeda refers to Minnie Miñoso as our Jackie Robinson, this is not hyperbole. This is the genuine regard that Latinos have for Minnie Miñoso. It was the hope that if Minnie made it, and then seeing how Minnie made it, that inspired so many Latinos. And Minnie Miñoso stood tall among the greats who came from the Negro Leagues. He was part of the bridge that brought us out of segregation into integration in baseball. I look forward to seeing Minnie Miñoso's family, Charlie, his son, Sharon, his widow. Others will see once again the tremendous amount of admiration that people have for Minnie Miñoso. Minnie earned this many years ago. We were slow, too slow, to get that honor to him, but he's got it, and he earned it. Minnie has his forever baseball home in Cooperstown. Now that is awesome.